Are you after Capitali? I got something new here. Might lead you to it. Got some new work, just in. Probably find some Capitali too. New opportunity here. Court to see a big man, Martelli. Time to see what all that Capitali gets you, huh? Now, I got something for you. Here, courtesy of one alarmingly perfumed Italian. Yeah, must be pleased with you. Good luck. I reckon you'll need it.
Senator Ricard, you recall we spoke of him? The man who has so foolishly been trying to make his reputation at the expense of my employer. He wishes to put himself and his beloved Lemoyne in the headlines of next year's Centennial State Fair in Sacramento. And he has devised quite the centerpiece. Three of the world's most famous jewels brought together for a single exhibit. Except, we will ensure they never meet. One by one, as they are taken west, you will find them. You will procure them. And if you value my friendship as highly as you should, you will bring them to me. Today's prize, the diamond. Il Sovrano. Pale yellow, so big you could not close it in your fist. If you believe the stories, it was stolen from a temple in India, and tragic fates have since befallen its owners. For Senator Ricard, we give the Kurds a little assistance. Yes, a consortium of your southern nobility have paid handsomely for the privilege of hosting the stone in Rhodes before it travels west. Tonight, the senator's representative comes to collect it. You will ensure that it never enters his possession.
Got a light? Anyone? Friend, you ain't got a light, have you? Though, careful, I spill some hooch around here. If you was planning to sleep in the stables, I recommend against it. Place as dry as a tinderbox. And dusty as hell. It'll get in your mouth. Dang. I need a drink.
Well, it's about that time, gentlemen.
Of course. Well, you must pass on our thanks to Senator Ricard.
It's been quite the thrill hosting the infamous Il Sovrano.
I shall pass that along.
Well, Uncle? He's been quite spellbound by the thing. Time to return the stone.
Of course, but, well...
How the hell? You need to leave!
Where is it?
Look now, sir. Don't blow your top. It's close by. Made a note of the location and everything right here in my pocket. But, well, yeah, as I was about to say to the Senator's esteemed representative here, Mr.,
Just Lieutenant will be fine, sir.
Well, yes, yes, of course. Well,
yeah,
Lieutenant, I've been thinking this affair, this
Now, how can I ease your troubles?
I mean,
we're proud to offer shelter from carpetbaggers and other rats.
Way, does it not? Why, it's nothing but a carnival. Common, cheap carnival. The civilized among us here in Rhodes are of a certain stock, and therefore in a far better position to exhibit this jewel in the manner to which it has surely become accustomed.
Yes, yes, I'm certain you would, sir, but this is the Centennial Fair, see? I assure you it is not a common carnival. The Il Serrano Diamond is the centerpiece exhibit, and Senator Ricard is expecting it to be there.
Of course, of course. I don't mean to be obstructive. If you'll please excuse me, nature calls.
So sorry for the complication. You must excuse him. He hasn't been himself since my Aunt Wilma died. A bit lonely, but I'm certain the stone is safe.
It had better be.
How do you do?
I am trying to remain civil out of respect for your uncle, but I am running out of patience. The jewel leaves with me today. That is not negotiable.
Yes, I understand. I'm sure he'll be right back.
You know, I traveled from sea to sea in my youth, but Rhodes is where I call home.
Why, hello there, sir.
Covered on all sides! Come on! Over!
country justice.
The treasures. I could never have thought I have one like this in my presence, let alone in my hands. You have done well, my friend.
Thank you.